Hey everyone, I'm Howard Pinsky, Senior XD Evangelist at Adobe. And if you're watching this video, there's a good chance that you've been working strictly in Photoshop, and that's totally fine, but you may be wanting a little bit more for your screen designs. Let me show you how you can open your existing Photoshop documents directly in Adobe XD and how they can work hand in hand to take your projects to new levels. Here I have a website which was designed in Photoshop that I'd love to expand on using Adobe XD. Thankfully, I don't need to recreate the entire thing from scratch. Opening up your Photoshop documents in XD is as simple as opening up your XD documents in XD. You can drag the file right onto the icon, or use the Open option under the File menu. Once it's all loaded in, you'll notice that just about everything transferred over correctly, allowing you to seamlessly continue your designing using many of the features that makes XD shine. For this project, I may want to quickly create a gallery of images in this section, and for that, a repeat grid will work beautifully. With the existing image selected, I'll press the repeat grid button to the right and drag out a few additional cards, both horizontally and vertically. Then I can adjust the padding to get it looking just right. With the gallery in place, I need some more images. Hopping over to Finder, I can select all these great looking shots, drag them onto any of the cards, and they'll populate the grid. Pretty neat. Let me create one more repeat grid down this page, this time using the Command or Control R shortcut. And in addition to dragging in images, plain text files can also be dropped to populate titles, descriptions, or any other type of text layer you may be working with. Great, I'm starting to like how this is looking, but I would love to see how it'll feel on a smaller display. With the entire artboard selected, I'll first duplicate it over to the right, and then I'm going to turn on Responsive Resize. Now, I'll drag the sides inwards, and once it's in a good place, I can focus on individual sides or groups. You might be noticing that instead of simply squishing the various elements that are on this page, Responsive Resize is keeping proportions intact. Finally, now that I'm happy with this design at various sizes, let's add a simple interaction. On the slimmer artboard, I first want to enable scrolling. This can be done by choosing vertical to the right. Then I can decrease the viewport height either in the property inspector or by dragging the handle up the artboard. Now everything above this handle will be visible immediately, while anything below it will only be visible on scroll. With that in place, I may want this image to enlarge with a tap. Duplicating this artboard one more time, I'll simply grab the group containing the image and text and enlarge it. Then to avoid any distractions, I'll select the group behind it and turn the opacity down to zero. Now that both states are in place, wiring this up is super simple. Jumping into prototype mode, I'll select the image to reveal the wire, which can then be dragged to the target artboard. I'll stick with tap for the trigger, but make sure that Auto Animate is selected under Action. This will instruct XD to look at the differences between the two artboards and animate everything that's changed. Finally, I'll set my desired easing and duration options. Now, when I go to preview my prototype, either on the desktop, web, or mobile, I can not only scroll down the artboard, but I can also tap on the image to enlarge it. And this was all accomplished with an imported Photoshop document. But there's so much more to learn and explore. Make sure to check out our other videos to crank up your knowledge on working with assets, repeat grids, responsive resize, in-depth prototyping, and a lot more. I'll see you soon.